Hello everyone, today we are going to study anti-metabolites, that is the next class of anti-cancer drugs. The anti-cancer drugs, that is the anti-metabolites, they work by inhibiting the synthesis of purines and pyrimidine nucleotides. Also they inhibit the enzymes which are required for DNA synthesis, and they may incorporate the false nucleotides and can stop replication, and finally the cell may die. So we'll just go back and revise the things. During the S phase of the cell cycle, the DNA replication occurs. Topoisomerase is the enzyme which unbinds or uncoils the DNA and exposes the bases. The helicase is an enzyme which helps to keep the two strands separate. Now DNA polymerase is an enzyme which helps to synthesize a new strand so that copies of DNA are synthesized. Now the base pairs are adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. Adenine and guanine are purine nucleotides and thymine and cytosine are pyrimidine nucleotides. During the DNA replication, this adenine always forms a bond with thymine and guanine always pairs with cytosine. So these nucleotides are synthesized during the de novo synthesis of purines and pyrimidines. So anti-metabolites work by inhibiting the synthesis of purine and pyrimidine. Also they inhibit the enzyme. Anti-metabolites are further classified as pyrimidine antagonists, the drugs which inhibit the synthesis of pyrimidine nucleotides, purine antagonist, the drugs which inhibits the synthesis of purine nucleotides, folate antagonists are the anti-metabolites which inhibit the dihydrofolate reductase enzyme, which is an important enzyme during the synthesis, de novo synthesis of purines and pyrimidines. So we are going to see these drugs one by one. Now we will continue with the de novo synthesis of pyrimidine. We are not going to go in very much detail of biochemistry, but this is the simplest pathway where you can see the carbon dioxide and amino acid glutamine. It forms carbamoyl phosphate. This carbamoyl phosphate in the presence of enzyme carbamoylase form carbamoyl aspartate, which gets converted to orotic acid. Here the pyrimidine nucleus is synthesized. This orotic acid is further converted to orotidine monophosphate, which undergoes decarboxylation to form uridine monophosphate. This uridine monophosphate in the presence of an enzyme kinase gets converted to UDP, that is uridine diphosphate for short, which undergoes a reaction in the presence of an enzyme kinase to UTP, that is uridine triphosphate, which is further converted to cytidine triphosphate. Cytidine triphosphate, CTP for short, which gets reduced to deoxycytidine triphosphate, which is then incorporated in the DNA. The concern for pyrimidine antagonist is this thymidylate synthetase. This UDP is then converted in the presence of an enzyme reductase to deoxy-UDP, that is deoxyuridine diphosphate, which further is converted to DUMP, that is deoxyuridine monophosphate. Now from this part, it is a very important part for the pyrimidine antagonist. This DUMP is a substrate for thymidylate synthetase, which takes the help of this methylene tetrahydrofolate cofactor to get converted into deoxy thymidine monophosphate, which is further converted to DTTP, that is deoxy thymidylate triphosphate, which is then incorporated in the DNA. Now here this side, the methylene tetrahydrofolate is converted to dihydrofolate, which is further reduced with the help of this dihydrofolate reductase enzyme to tetrahydrofolate, with just the addition of a methylene group gets converted to the active form of cofactor again. So our enzymes, so our anti-metabolite drugs, they work by inhibiting this enzyme, that is thymidylate synthetase, that is pyrimidine antagonist. For example, the fluorouracil works by inhibiting this enzyme, and the folate antagonist, they work by inhibiting this enzyme, that is dihydrofolate reductase. As a result, the DTMP is not formed and the DNA is not synthesized and the cell dies. De novo synthesis of purines requires different amino acids like glycine, glutamine and aspartate, which utilizes ribose 5-phosphate and 5-phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate to form inosine monophosphate, IMP, which is an important precursor for the synthesis of adenosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate. We'll go through the de novo synthesis of purines. D-ribose 5-phosphate gets converted to 5-phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate in the presence of an enzyme synthetase. Then the enzyme phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate amidotransferase catalyzes the conversion of PRTP to till inosine monophosphate with a series of reactions wherein these amino acids forms that purine nucleus. The inosine monophosphates get converted to adenyl succinate in the presence of an enzyme adenyl succinase. Adenyl succinate in the presence of an enzyme succinase forms an important adenosine monophosphate, which gets reduced to deoxy-AMP, which further is reduced to DATP, adenosine triphosphate, which is then incorporated in the DNA. To the other side, the inosine monophosphate undergoes dehydrogenation in the presence of an enzyme dehydrogenase to form xanthine monophosphate or xanthosine monophosphate, that is XMP for short, which forms an important GMP, that is guanosine monophosphate. GMP is further reduced to deoxy-GMP, ultimately to DGTP, which is then incorporated in the DNA. This is the normal biochemical pathway of de novo synthesis of purines. Now purine antagonists, they work by inhibiting this PRPP amidotransferase enzyme. This is the first enzyme which is responsible for the complete pathway. So this is inhibited by the purine antagonist. The examples of these drugs are 6-mercaptopurine and 6-thioguanine. These purine antagonists also inhibit the enzyme succinase, which converts adenyl succinate to AMP. That means the further DAMP is not formed and DATP is not incorporated in the DNA. Ultimately, the replication of DNA stops. Also, it inhibits the enzyme dehydrogenase, which converts inosine monophosphate to xanthosine monophosphate. Now we will study the drugs individually, which are important which are important as purine antagonist. Thank you for watching.